In this video, we are going to cover a nice, new, powerful function called PivotPy. In simple terms, it allows you to create pivot tables without pivot tables. Our data is in a table, and the table has a name called X. Usually, I will create a pivot table. I'm going to put card and gender and amount. But if I add a new type of card, it doesn't reflect immediately in a pivot table. I have to say right click refresh. And many people want this to happen live. And that is what the pivot by function does. So let's see how to use this function. There are lots of parameters, but primarily what to put in rows, what to put in columns, what to put in values, and what is the summary function to use. Row fields, X is the table name, square bracket gives me this. So I'm going to choose card. In the columns, I want genders. In the values field, I want amount, and in the name of the function, I just put sum. We got exactly the same table. And right now, I'm going to add a new type of card called whatever, AA card. And notice it is live refreshed. I'm not going to go into all the parameters, but there is one thing which is not obvious, and that is what I'm going to cover. For example, in a typical pivot table, I can put card and category. So this becomes two fields in the row area. So same thing I want to do with my pivot function. Now pivot by says row fields, correct? But if I put two fields, see what happens. Right now I'm going to put card, and immediately after that, the moment I press comma, now whatever I'm going to type, it is going to take it as column fields. But I don't want the next field as a column field. I want it as a row field, and that's where people get confused. So in order to have more than one item in either row or column fields, we have to use another function called hstack, horizontal stack. This is also one of the new functions. And now I can give a list. There's one, comma, another one. It's basically asking for multiple arrays, and then it's going to put them together horizontally. The second one I want is, let's say, category. And now when I complete the hstack bracket, I'm still in the row fields parameter. Then comma will now take me to column fields, where I will still put gender. The value is from amount, and the function to be used is sum. And that's how you get multiple items or fields in rows, and same concept can be used for columns as well. In our case, the column card and category are next to each other. So I really did not need to use hstack. I could have just selected it like this, and then this is the syntax. I could have typed it directly. But in real life, it's unlikely that all the columns you want are going to be adjacent. That's why knowing hstack is more important than just using the default formula. The rest of the parameters talk about embellishments to the pivot table, like should it have field headers or not? Row total, totals and grand total, should they be shown or not? What should be the sort order for rows and columns? Now, does it mean pivot table is completely gone? No. Pivot table is a very established, sophisticated, feature-rich set of tools. And they are not going to go out of date. But if you want quick and easy live refresh, this is the way to go. If you are interested in a final report which is good to look at, then still pivot table is better because it has lots of formatting options. All of them you will have to implement manually in pivot by function. Remember, this is an Office 365 version of Excel. So if you send this file to someone who doesn't have Office 365 version of Excel, it's not going to work. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.